this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you, and we got a special guest on the show today, Jake Mays from the Vegan Athlete Channel. I've been to his place, he's been to my place, we've made videos at each other's places. He's got an amazing desert garden going on in Arizona, but today I got him to come to Las Vegas, Nevada for the 2017 National Hardware Show, also co-located with the Lawn and Garden Show, and that's why I'm here today. And Jake has helped me out being my cameraman, but also he's gonna be making his own video here, maybe even covering stuff that I won't cover in my video, about some of the cool stuff he sees. So Jake, you wanna say any words to my viewers today?
You know, I love the Growing Your Greens audience because I was once just an audience member and I was inspired by your garden videos to do my garden and to do YouTube videos, honestly.
Cool.
So I'm glad we can do this together, kind of hang out, and I hope that folks can go back and forth to our videos and see behind the scenes and in front of the scenes.
Right, yeah, so in my video, you're gonna get in front of the scenes, and in Jake's video, you're gonna get to see a lot of the behind the scenes stuff that you never see in my videos, right? I just make the videos and show you guys and tell you guys what's exactly up, but before I even make my video, I might be talking to the people at the, you know, booth for a half hour, maybe 45 minutes, learning about the product, being able to understand what it does, and then being able to explain it to you guys. And so Jake's gonna get a lot of that cool behind the scenes stuff if you really want the extra stuff.
And I never do conventions like this, so I'm a total virgin, and you're gonna show me the way.
Yeah, so I'm gonna show them the ropes here at the hardware show, because this is the business about hardware and garden lawn and supply, but this is where a lot of really cool products that'll allow you to grow your own food at home. Now, I will come out right and say I have not sold out, you know, and while you do not need any of these products to grow food, some of them can make it easier for you guys to grow food more effectively, and maybe even just get you started if you're a noob and you've never gardened before, and maybe just buying a raised bed kit will allow you to garden. Hey, I think that's a good thing. Anything that can get you guys to become more of a producer than a consumer is definitely a step in the right direction. That being said, you don't need none of this crap to grow food, right? So,
you know, on my Vegan Athlete YouTube channel, I do a lot of fruit trees. Are they gonna have fruit tree stuff in there?
I mean, they might have fruit tree fertilizer, they might have some places that sell fruit trees, but we'll see what happens, man.
Maybe things to help conserve water?
I'm sure they'll have some things that conserve water, because water is a precious resource and we should not squander it. All right, Jake, so Jake's gonna be my cameraman today, so basically he's behind the scenes in my video, he's in the front of the scenes in his video. Once again, link is down below, but at the end of this episode, we're gonna get Jake back in the episode, and we're gonna just go ahead and chat about some of our favorite products that we saw at this year's show. So Jake, ready to head in?
I'm excited.
All right, let's do it. So now we're inside the hardware show in the New Inventors area. This is where I find a lot of really cool, new, and innovative products. And actually, there's one here I want to share with you guys real quick. Over here we have is the tree diaper. So this is literally a diaper for your trees, right? The inventor, who's a mom, basically discovered this because she had a little baby. And she was like, how could I reuse, recycle the polymers that are inside the diaper? So when your baby goes to the bathroom in the diaper, these polymers basically expand so your baby's butt don't get wet, right? But then after that, thousands of millions of diapers go into the landfill each and every year. It's insane the waste that's being generated. So she thought, how could I reuse these polymers to use in my garden, use around the house? What could I do with them? So she invented the tree diaper using these polymers, or reusing them, which was her prototype after, you know, cleaning them properly, to basically conserve water, hold moisture, and then feed it to your trees, your raised bed garden, your plants. And this is how she came up with the idea of the tree diaper. And but now these are not being made out of used diapers. I just want to let you guys know they have industrial, you know, landscape polymers that they're putting in to the tree diaper, which is the same similar thing that they use actually in diapers. And this is what it looks like right here. In the picture, it looks like a big tire that you basically put underneath your tree when it's full. Now, when it's not full, this is what it looks like. It just looks like, you know, some weed fabric cloth, and on the back side, it's basically like kind of like a mesh plastic. And inside here, there's all these little beads, these little polymer beads. Now, these polymer beads will expand like, I don't know, 100 times its size. size and holds so much water in there when it's raining or when you're watering your trees or plants, right? It's gonna store the water and then release it at a slow and even rate to your plants, like even slower than a drip system would. And you know, for those of you guys that go on vacation to have a garden that you don't wanna trust your significant other, your friend, your neighbor to water your trees when you're gone or your plants, you could get one of these and you wanna dunk it in like a 5-gallon bucket, right? And this will charge up. And this guy right here looks pretty small, right? This one will hold nearly a 1/4 gallon of water. And then it'll slowly release over time. And they make these guys from this small 10 inch all the way up to a super huge 48 inch size, I believe, that holds 30 gallons of water for your big trees. So this is probably best for your big trees because the big trees are quite an investment, right? A small tomato plant maybe costs a couple bucks. You might've started the seeds, but some of the big trees could cost 50, 100, maybe $1,000 for these big huge trees. So this is literally cheap insurance for you guys when you go on vacation. And even more so, this conserves and saves water. If you live in an environment that rains throughout the year, but you know, might rain this week, might rain in 2 weeks, this will charge up when it's raining and then release the water. So, you know, where the inventor lives in Virginia, right? They could use this without actually having to do supplementary watering of some of the trees, plants, and shrubs around the inventor's home. So now, guess what? Now you're watering your plants entirely with rainwater instead of using the city water that may contain chlorine and other things. So this is simply amazing. Let me go ahead and show you guys more how the tree diaper works. So this is basically a tree diaper, unexpanded. This is how you'd get it in the mail. It comes like all folded up for you. Really, it's really light actually. And then when it rains, this charges up. It doesn't charge up from the top necessarily. Some water might charge through the top, but basically it's charging from the bottom. So when the soil is moist, anything that comes in contact with these little beads will act like a sponge and these will expand. And this is what an expanded bag looks like right here. So here's the unexpanded, and here's the expanded one. And this looks kind of like a, you know, spare tire. It's like really puffy. And underneath here now, all the little gel things have been expanded. And like if we squeeze it, you can see the water seep out of there ever so slowly. Look at that, ever so slowly. Now if it's just sitting there on your soil, right, as the soil gets dry, the water will go to where it's drier and seep in slowly, so it'll slowly water your plants, trees, or shrubs. So one of the things that I've been you know, cautious about in the past, because people have asked me about, John, what about these polymers, right? You know, it's used in some soil blend. Some landscapers actually mix it in the soil and then put it into the ground. Do you recommend that? And you know, I mean, the research is out. You know, I'm always cautious of new technology, especially when it's plastics and all this kind of stuff, right? And so like my recommendation is, while it can be effective and can be helpful because this stuff does work, you know, if you mix it into your soil, you don't know the long-term effects because this is relatively new technology. But now that they have it in the tree diaper where it's totally 100% encapsulated, you can get the benefits of the polymer without actually having to mix it into your soil. So for this reason, I think it's really beneficial, and actually I would use this to help conserve water, especially in a dry, arid climate where, you know, it's so dry. And plus, I travel a lot, so getting my trees and plants watered can be challenging, but this guy is gonna help out because I could charge these up before I leave, and, you know, depending on the size of the tree diaper you have, you could be gone for, you know, potentially a month, you know. So yeah, that's really cool. That's how this guy works. They have a lot of different sizes, and once again, here's how it looks. It almost looks like a spare tire. Now, if you thought this was pretty ugly, right, to have under your tree and you wouldn't want to really want it like this, that's all right. You could actually just mulch over the top of this. It's probably even more effective, especially with the sun hitting the black. It'll probably heat up a lot, but if you mulch over it with some nice wood chips, that'll keep this cooler, so it's gonna work a lot better. I really look forward to using this tree diaper in my garden. And besides just using it in trees, they got also a raised bed kits right here with a preset spacing. So I think on a raised bed kit they have, it looks like a, you know, a hole maybe every 12 inches. And unless you want to modify this and sew it and whatnot, you got to use their spacing on the tree diaper. If you guys want to learn more about the tree diaper, you can check them out at treediaper.com. So now I want to show you guys another cool booth here at the National Hardware Show, Lawn and Garden Show, and it's this booth right here. It's the Soil Savvy booth, and they provide professional soil test kits. Now, for those of you guys that know me, I haven't really ever promoted a soil test kit before. You know, a lot of the soil test kits that you guys do, that local universities do and so many other places do, right? You dig up your soil, you put it in a little container, you send it to them, then the place gets your soil, they open it up, they basically burn your soil to basically see what's in your soil, right? And that's good just to know what's in your soil, but that does nothing to tell you guys what is actually available to your plant, because just because it's in your soil doesn't mean that it could be unlocked and be available for your plant. And that's why I like the Soil Savvy Professional Test Kit, because that's what this test kit does. It's unlike any other soil test kit you've seen before. This has a patent on it. So let me go ahead and explain to you guys how this works. So basically, you're gonna get a test kit, comes like this. They sell it on Amazon right now. It's about $25, quite inexpensive. And inside here, there's only a few things. Super simple, super easy. Number one, postage paid, so you don't have to pay for postage to send this back. You get a little scoop here, and all you need to do is just get a scoop of your soil, right? And I would recommend you guys get a scoop of your soil where you're growing your actual plants, right? Don't do it off in the corner where you're not growing anything. Do it right in your raised bed where you are actually growing your plants, right? Then you're gonna take this scoop out. All right, and then you're gonna put it in this little collection vial. Now, I'm not gonna open this collection vial up because you're not supposed to open this up until you're actually gonna add your soil to it. You see it has a little seal on there. So if you get one of these that doesn't have the seal on that, call them up and tell them, hey, I want one with the seal, because you gotta make sure that whatever's inside here, which is basically some deionized water, really pure water, and these little polymer crystals have to be contaminant-free to get an accurate test. I can't open this up, but they got one open here. And so what's in there is looks like this right here. It's these little polymer crystals. And this is the reason why this soil test kit kicks ass over any other soil test kit that you may have heard before, because what this little polymer here does, once you put your soil in there and the deionized water, this acts like your root, right? So this will, these little polymers will actually absorb the nutrients just like your plant root would. So this simulates your plant root. No other soil test on earth does this. So then what happens is the soil, the deionized water, and this sits in there for about 5 days, and this will absorb all the nutrients that your plant could be absorbing. So this actually is a test kit that tells you what is available to your plants. And that's the most important test you could do, aside from a food soil web test, which measures, you know, the microbes and the beneficial soil life in your plants. This tells you what's available to your plants. That's super critical, super important. And then basically after about 7 days, after you mail this in, after about 7 days, they're basically gonna email you a report back, and it's gonna look like this. You're gonna tell them that you are a vegetable gardener and you're growing your food. And you're gonna get a PDF file that's gonna pretty much look like this, and it's gonna give you a test data of about over a dozen different nutrients, macronutrients and micronutrients. So of course you got the NPK in there, which everybody's like worships NPK, but you know, there's more to gardening and growing food than just the NPK. It's all about some of these other, you know, micronutrients. So they have some trace minerals in here, not as many as I would like. They are working on expanding this to, you know, other minerals, both beneficial and also harmful minerals, such as cadmium, to make sure that your soil is not contaminated, for instance. And they're basically going to tell you what is available to your plant, and then you're going to have to make adjustments, and they will recommend, you know, synthetic ways to do this, which I don't recommend, and they'll recommend organic ways to do this, which I would encourage you guys to recommend. Now, in my opinion, based on talking to them, you know, their database may not be fully complete on all their organic recommendations. So, you know, you might want to check out with somebody that's, you know, knows a lot about organics and other things if you have specific nutrient needs for specific nutrients. And then the main thing you're going to look for is this target area. So even if you don't know anything else, if you guys are in this target area right here and you're in that zone all the way across, you're in pretty good shape, right? So it looks like this soil test is in pretty good shape. You know, maybe the nitrogen looks a bit low on this one, but everything looks in range or maybe a little bit high. And you know, here's the thing, you don't want things too high, you don't want things too low, you want them just right, you know. Minerals could be good or they could be bad, and it's not because of the minerals good or bad, it's the concentration of the mineral is good or bad. And literally that is what this tells you. Now, on the back it gives you some, you know, general information about, you know, some of the different components and what they do and how important they are. But yeah, that's pretty much this test kit, man. I would encourage you guys to get one of these guys so you can see where you're at. I'm gonna be getting some of these test kits to run in my garden. I'll have an episode dedicated to testing my food and testing my garden. Oh, and the other thing I want to mention, you guys, this shows you guys what is available in your soil for your plants. And then with that information, you could also surmise the nutrition that will be in your plants, because if it's available for your plants, if your plants are taking it up, that's the nutrition that's gonna be in there. So that's why I would encourage you guys to, you know, trust a soil test like this that actually simulates the plant roots versus one of the ones that just shows what's available in the soil but not necessarily what's in the plant. But yeah, I'll be making another episode, so be sure to click that subscribe button right down below to be notified of new upcoming episodes when I make my soil test with the Soil Savvy Professional Test Kit and share my results with you guys. Hopefully it'll be in pretty good shape. So if you guys want to learn more about the Soil Savvy Test Kit, you want to check out the website unibestinc.com, and it's available right now for you guys on Amazon. One of the best deals on a legitimate soil test kit I've found. So now I want to share with you guys the next exhibitor I want to highlight for you guys. And actually this is a really cool exhibitor right here, and it's actually the Vegepod vegetable garden kits. This was designed in Australia because the gardener saw a need and he filled it. And literally what it is, it's right here. This is basically a raised bed kit, but it's not any old raised bed kit, because I've featured those before. This is actually a self-watering raised bed kit that could actually be used on the ground, or actually you could put on one of their many different stands. This one happens to be on wheels. Let me go ahead and show you guys how it looks. The reason why I like this raised bed kit, because it's a 100% self-contained kit. You'll need to buy nothing further except the soil and the plants you're gonna fill it with. It actually comes with a cover here that's gonna keep out your pests. You know, I know a lot of you guys might get aphids, whiteflies, cabbage worms, tomato hornworms, right? Keep this cover down, you're not gonna get any of these pests on your garden. In addition, birds and other wildlife, and in, I guess, Australia where this was designed, they got kangaroos that'll eat your vegetables. I wanna see that, that's gonna be fun. But this guy actually clips down, so I mean, I'm tugging on this, and you gotta tug pretty hard, and check it out, man. All your plants are inside, protected from the elements, but this is the least amount of shade cloth. I think it's like a 17% shade, so it's gonna get most of the light, and all the water could actually still come through there if it's raining for you. And you're thinking, John, what about pollination, man? Like, if I got this down, how are the bees gonna pollinate the stuff? So, you know, even though this is down, the wind could blow, and wind will blow pollen, right? There's ants and other creatures that'll still be able to like get inside here and pollinate some of the crops. And some more crops, delicate crops that may need some pollination, could be artificially inseminated. I like that. Like, you know, zucchinis and whatnot. You might have to just take a little, you know, sonic care vibrating toothbrush and vibrate some of the pollen off and help it along a little bit to get it going. So that's why I really see the value of this. Of course, if you want to get self-pollinating, you could leave that up, but then you're gonna have to deal with all the other bugs and bacteria, you know, that may get inside, or, you know, the bad bugs. But yeah, so they got this small version, which is pretty small. Like, I wouldn't really waste my money on this unless maybe you had a small patio or something like that. This one retails, just the garden itself is $129, and then you have an optional stand on wheels. This guy's the bigger size. It's about 3 feet by 3 feet. This one's about $199. And then they have the jumbo one, the one I like the most actually. It's $299, and this is where the really value comes in. You know, the bigger size, you're basically just getting 1, 2, 3, 4 of the smallest size. And check this out, man, this thing is huge. The cool thing is, if you've never put anything together before, you know, this is really easy to assemble. All the instructions are included. It comes in this one box right here. So you could easily get this shipped to you, pick it up, and you know, it includes the tools so you could actually put it together. And let me show you guys how this works. So this is an empty one. And so once you assemble this, they have these little trays that go in the bottom that basically make a hollow floor on the bottom. And you're gonna fill all this up with soil. Now let's talk about the soil. It's very important. You gotta get the right soil blend in here because this works on a wicking system. So you're gonna put a potting soil in here, a good potting soil. I like the Dr. Earth's brand of potting soil, the orange bag, one of the best ones. Fill that up in here, and then you could basically water this, and the water is gonna store in this reservoir. So this tray here will hold about 4 gallons. So that's 4, 8, 12, 16. So this whole unit will hold 16 gallons underneath. And don't worry about it if you overfill it. There's a little drain plug right over here where the water is gonna run out if you overfill it, so you could never overfill it. I would recommend actually putting a bucket underneath that little drain hole so any water that comes out, you could actually put it back into the system. This way you're gonna be able to save water, and water is a precious resource in this day and age, especially if you're in California, even though they're out of the drought now. The other thing that's really cool about this setup here is that it actually has a built-in mist system. So I don't know if you guys can see that up at the top, there's a black tube there with little misters that you can actually just hook up into a hose, into your irrigation system, and you can put it on a timer so it could actually automatically come on and water from the top if you want to get a little bit more water. So while this can be used on one of their amazing stands, you could actually also put this on the ground. So this would be great if you're renting a place or you don't own your home and you want to take it with you when you move, like if you're in a rental house or apartment, you could get one of these for your patio. It's not gonna damage the ground or anything. You could put it on these stands here, which are actually powder coated and fully protected. If this is not high enough for you, you could get some like concrete blocks and jack it up a little bit higher. You could cut these off to make it a little bit lower. Or of course, you guys could just build your own out of wood, which would probably be a lot less expensive than buying one of their fancy ones. But actually, I gotta say, all this metal work is really nice. I mean, this would be perfect for people that need an accessible garden that may be in a wheelchair, or for older people that don't want to like bend down and be in the ground all the time. So yeah, I mean, this is the Vegepod kit. I really like, check this out. I could put this whole thing down, and I really like that it includes this whole fabric cover. And this has like, I think a one year warranty on the top, 2 years on the bottom. And the cool thing is, when you gotta buy replacement parts for it, it's super cheap. Like this whole fabric top here, if it should wear out, and this is based on a commercial growers over in Australia that grew fruit trees, this is only like $20 for this whole new top cover, which is amazing, because you know, a lot of places will rip you off, and $20, that seems like an affordable price to replace this whole top cover. But yeah, you could grow bug free, save water, throw some plants, and all at the same time in the comfort of your own patio or a backyard with the Vegepod. You want to learn more about them, you can visit them at veggiepod.com. Wow, so this must have been one of the shortest episodes for a hardware show with Lawn and Garden Show that I've ever been to. You know, Jake and I were here, we've been here like 8 hours walking the whole floor of the lawn and garden area plus some of the hardware area to try to find some of the coolest products, and I was only able to find a handful for you guys.
But you've also seen a bunch of them before.
Yeah, so a lot of the stuff was like the stuff that's been here before, and it's just like nothing new. So I want to remind you guys, check down below into the description where I have links to my prior year's videos, because you know, a lot of companies have the same old stuff, you know, this year, and I'm not gonna be showing like the same stuff that I showed last year if I already put it in a video for you guys. But Jake actually filmed a few other products that actually didn't make it into my video that he thought was cool. So check out his channel for that, as well as some of the more updated info. So Jake, you wanna give a shout out for your channel and whatnot?
Yeah, I got a couple of them, but it'll be on the Vegan Athlete channel. So if you go on YouTube, type in Jake Mace. I got two channels, one is martial arts and one is gardening. So go to the gardening channel called Vegan Athlete, and I'll put it up the same day you put yours up, so we'll kind of go in sync.
All right, cool. So, I mean, this was your first time at one of these events, right?
Like, I never do stuff like this.
Right, so what did you think of this event? Is it crazy? Is it just insane? What are your just honest thoughts for my viewers?
Honestly?
Yeah, honestly, man.
I mean, my body feels like it feels after I do like a full day of like museum, like going to the Metropolitan Museum of Art or something. I feel broken down like looking at art all day, because we looked at art in terms of the booths. But I also forget sometimes, I think even though I try not to be in a bubble, I think I am kind of in a bubble of gardening and veganism and self-sufficient lifestyle and things like that, and martial arts, fitness. So when I do events like this with the regular people that are executives and they're running companies, I'm a little out of my comfort zone. And whether it's just us being in the lunchroom to see what people eat, normal people, is scary. I mean, everybody had a cheeseburger with double bacon on it. And that's just scary to me. And there's so much excess in that room. There's so many products that feature plastic.
Yeah.
And there are so many products that feature leather and metal. I just wonder in my brain, like, where is the earth getting all this product from? And how are we living in a way that's supporting this kind of excess, like, retail purchasing power? You come to these events and you're shedding light on people who are actually doing sustainable things.
Or products that are at least better, that are gonna be helpful for you in some way so that you guys could grow more food,
right,
and become a producer, right? And, you know, let's not joke ourselves, everybody's not gonna go and be a hippie and live off the land with nothing. So, but we could all take steps to make small changes in our lives today to make a difference for tomorrow. And by buying and consuming less things, and by buying good, high quality products, and that's what I try to do. I come here and show you guys everything. Some of the manufacturers will send me some samples and whatnot, and then I'll try them and I'll review them for you guys and let you guys know my honest opinion. And I'll tell you guys my honest opinion. I don't really care.
I'm a pretty positive guy, and I always try to use the Buddhist way of do no harm with your words, but you're very, very blatantly honest in there.
I'm just being me, man. Like, I want people to tell it to me like it is.
Like, you're with the inventors of these compost tumblers, and you're telling them what it should have, what it shouldn't have, and they're listening to you because they want to make a product that's good for the gardeners out there.
I mean, I don't want to get a product that's like crap and it's junk. Like, that, then it's a waste of all the plastic resources and metal and everything they've used to make it if it's a piece of junk from the get-go.
So at least out in 6 months.
Right, so or if it's malfunctioning because it wasn't designed properly, because these designers, most of the designers we met today, I don't think they garden and actually really use the products they make, because some of the ways that they make this stuff is insane.
Yeah, we kept asking people, like, do you have fruit trees? Do you have a garden? And none of them do personally.
Right.
They all have all the info to tell you, but none of them are doing it at their home.
Right.
That was weird to me.
Yeah, it's weird.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah.
And you're featuring the people that are helping grow food, but what percentage of that was the whole conference, you think?
Oh man, just freaking hardly anything. That's why, like, my videos, you know, I focus on growing food. I mean, right, I can talk about all kinds of other gardening trinkets and junk, but like, I see no use for most of this stuff here. I mean, in the hardware side, there's actually a lot of cool tools, right, and I'm a tool guy, man, because if a tool allows you to fix your own car or do something, take off your fan belt or whatever, and you can do it yourself instead of actually paying somebody else to do it for you, you're saving money, and a tool will save you money in the long run. So I'm a big fan of tools, good quality tools. Except if I don't have money, I'm gonna use it once and have harbor free.
There were so many booths in there that didn't have anything to do with gardening, and it was just like this Amazon rainforest of consumer retail crapola.
Yeah, no, I mean, I agree, man.
But it was like, it was so much. I mean, I try to live a minimalist lifestyle, and that was not.
This is the world, but this is what the world is coming to, you know, and I just got to be the change for good and try to share with you guys my honest opinions about things, and I want you encourage you guys to reduce, reuse, recycle, you know, buy less. Do you really need it? You know, buy things in bulk, buy things in less packaging, and buy good quality stuff that's going to last a long time. So when you do have to buy something, because we all have things we need and can use, you know, buy good quality stuff that's going to last a while. So the other question I have for you, Jake, is what's your favorite booth that you saw with me today?
Oh, the first one that we did.
You liked the first one the most?
It was the tree diaper.
Tree diaper, yeah.
That had the ability to conserve water around the tree's root zone. I'm only excited because they suggested you bury the tree diaper in mulch.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go home and try that, because I got one, a 36
inch. 36 inch, yeah.
So if you guys want to follow me on Being an Athlete, I'll do an episode with the tree diaper and I'll cover it over a few weeks and see how it does.
Yeah. Well, he's going to put it to the test. I don't have any large trees. You know, or I'm not going to use a tree diaper. I got some 10-inch ones, and they're going to send me some for later because I do think it's a good idea. But once again, I want to investigate it fully before I, you know, commit to recommending it to you guys. But I always like to bring you guys the latest technology and things that can help you guys out as a gardener.
When are you going to get your 100-acre fruit tree farm?
Why'd you have to ask me that in the video, man? You know, so here's the thing.
Everybody out there wants to see John Kohler get some land, and they want to see what kind of food Amazon.
I don't know that I'm going to be able to, like, 100 acres, that's too much, man. I mean, maybe 10, like 5 to 10, I mean, I'm just like one person and it's a lot. It's a lot of work, man, you know?
Well, I got some vegan athlete muscle. I'll come over and I'll help you plant some trees.
Cool.
I promise, no matter where it is.
I don't know where it's going to be yet. And Lauren didn't, you know, we went to Hawaii recently. She said she didn't really want to move to Hawaii. So maybe Puerto Rico, South Texas is still in the works. She kind of liked Florida, but I don't really particularly care for Florida too much. So we're kind of like
Thailand,
still hanging.
I'm coming.
So in Thailand, you can't actually own land if you're a foreigner in Thailand, actually, I've heard, so I think so. Anyways. But any final comments for my viewers today before we got to sign off?
You know, I think it's important to put yourself in situations in life that are outside your comfort zone because you'll learn something. So I learned a lot of things today. I met some people I wouldn't have met otherwise. I probably made some contacts in there that will pan out in the long run. And being with a guy who's done it before, like John, now I kind of know how big, you know, conventions like this work. And maybe if I see one in the future, maybe I'll attend it on my own because of this event. So put yourself in positions that are outside your comfort zone and do something that frightens you every day because you'll grow that way.
Wow, wise words. I definitely agree. And yeah, I mean, I come to these events. I've been coming to these for years for you guys, right? I want to show you guys the latest and newest products that can help you guys out, because any new product may get you excited about gardening. It may solve a problem that you guys have, and that's, you know, good use of the products instead of just things that are useless products. And there's a lot of those here too. But yeah, I mean, we're here all day, 8 hours, and I normally come more than one day to do all my filming. This trip, actually, we got another event we got to drive to tonight.
Yeah, so what are we doing now?
Quite busy. Yeah, we're going to a YouTube creators event over in Palm Springs. So hopefully I'll be able to find some cool, you know, farms and gardens and stuff to visit while we're there.
Be cool.
All right, man. So if you guys enjoyed this episode, hey, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. Also, be sure to share this with somebody. You know, that's going to help me out. Also be sure to click that subscribe button right down below to be notified of my new and upcoming episodes that are coming out about every 3 to 4 days. And be sure to check my past episodes, over 1,250 episodes on this YouTube channel dedicated to teach you guys all aspects of growing your own food at home. And also be sure to check those links down below to Jake's channel, as well as my previous episodes at the National Hardware Lawn and Garden Show.
Or your Growing Your Greens Instagram.
Yeah, check out my Growing Your Greens Instagram. Thanks, Jake.
Jake Makes Tai Chi Instagram.
Jake Makes Tai Chi. Right on, Jake. All right, we got to get running. So once again, this is John Kohler and
Jake Mace.
GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time. Until then, remember, keep on growing.